It's me, Mikey Pipes. Thanks for tuning in. This is a very special and unique job. Let me explain. This homeowner in this approximately 2,500 square foot house has a humidity issue. He doesn't got enough of it. The problem here is humidity. It's too dry in the house. We have a brand new Bosch IDS 2.0 4-ton heat pump system, which is primarily used for air conditioning. They like it warm in the house, and even though they have a Lochinvar Noble Fire 2 Combi, they like it like 74 degrees in the house, which is hot. That's hot. So if your wife is hot, you better get the AC fixed, right? So what's happening is that my humidity in this house is, on colder days, you know, 10, 12, 13%. And his wife is up in arms, complaining. The kids are complaining. Everyone's complaining to him. He's yelling at them. Everyone's yelling at him. And what does he do? He calls Mikey Pipes. And Mikey Pipes, you got to do something for me. Whatever it costs, whatever the means, you got to give me humidity. I'm like, why don't you get some like tabletop units from Amazon and fill them with water every so often, right? Every day. He goes, Mike, I tried that. It doesn't work. I'm like, all right. Well, the problem here is that we have ductwork in an attic, two floors up above us, that we can utilize for adding humidity. And that's what we're going to do. Watch this. Here is the garage, right? Is it conditioned space? The answer is no, right? It is not. It's insulated, but it's not heated. Here is the Aprilaire 800 steam humidifier. We just ran half-inch expansion PECs from the boiler room on the other side of the house to here. We have a hole right here in the ceiling, which then goes through the closet above us and then goes into the attic. We're going to run 1-inch radiator hose from the steam humidifier here across the ceiling, up the inside wall of the closet, and into the air handler return plenum. All right, so at this point of the install of this Aprilaire 800 steam humidifier, giving him what he wants, I realized that using 3/4-inch M tubing is no bueno. And then I realized this. There's no problems, there's only solutions. Stay tuned. We're going to take some shots along the way. So I realized, you know what? Let's call an auto parts store, like Parts Authority. And let's see if they have a roll of 1-inch radiator hose, maybe by 20 feet long. It'd be plenty. I can run from point A to point B. I don't have to put any copper in line, and it'll be perfect. Because if it can handle, you know, hot antifreeze going through, you know, an engine, a car engine, sure the hell can handle steam. All right, we're going to use the half-inch expansion PECs to run a water line to that humidifier. So, Peter, do the honors. Let's expand that, and we're going to slide it over that Whetstone half-inch slip by half-inch PEX A coupling. Four, go. All right, hold that there for like a 10-second count, because you went a little extra on the expansion, and then we should be good to go. And you're gonna notice that the tip, right, is a little dirty there, right? And you're probably gonna see that on the inside. Sorry. Of the pecs, right? I'd like to let go now. All right, we're good. Yep. Nice and tight. All right, and what's great about, yes, it is the cocky. What's great about the expansion packs is, right, it spends its entire life going back to that original size. Yeah. So we have full flow going through here, which is great. It's going to be great for this humidifier. By the way, if you want any free stickers, email me, mike@mikeypipes.com. Here's my half-inch water line. There's a 1/4-inch connection right there. I really wish I had an expansion packs angle valve in 1/4-inch, but I have it in 3/8. So I improvised, and I know you guys have done this before as well. Here is a piece of 3/8, and here's a piece of 1/4-inch, and I soldered them together. Sorry, it's a little blurry there. All right. And that's going to be our water connection to the humidifier. All right. There's our water line. Leak free. Little quarter turn valve there. It's nice. Little bend. Nice and tits.
This is the house where I made my Christmas
save. Yes. This is the house where I made you come back on a Friday night, which was your birthday, to fix the air conditioning that wasn't cooling. You remember that too, right?
I remember when he left.
Yeah, I remember that. All right. We have a 25-foot roll of 1-inch radiator hose, and we're going to shove it into the hole. All right. Let me show you what we got done so far. That corner, that's the garage. And we go all the way up, right up there, to the attic. We come across, and then we shoot into our injection bar, which I have on the return side. On the Nest, we go into settings, all right? I'm gonna go to equipment. All right, continue. And you're gonna notice that humidifier is there now. That's because that star wire, right, is going to one line of my humidifier, you know, the humidistat control on the steam unit. There's two wires. So one wire is going to star, and the other wire is going to C. All right? And now you'll see that star is there. All right, here's the final product. We need a switch plate on there, but we're good. It's gonna take up to 24 hours before this thing really humidifies the house, but nonetheless, we got lucky here. We had a drain there, so we just cut in a trap and a standpipe for the drain, and we're good.